Now you can try this question. Sketch a predicted proton NMR spectrum of ethanol, showing signal in the expected chemical shift ranges and with the appropriate number peaks in each. Note that hydrogen atom bonded to oxygen and nitrogen do not usually show coupling, but often exhibit a single broad peak instead. So now you can pause the video and try yourself. Now I am showing your answer, that ethanol. So you can see here CH3CH2OH. This is ethanol. The chemical formula of ethanol is CH3CH2OH. Now you can see in the ethanol there are three type of protons. One is CH3, another one is CH2, and one is OH. Now if you see the ball stick model of ethanol, this is CH3, this is CH2, and this is O, and this is H. For this CH3, the splitting pattern of the CH3 will be depend upon the neighboring carbon having hydrogen. So this have two hydrogen, so 2 plus 1 3, so we will get a triplet for these three hydrogen. And for this two hydrogen, we will get neighboring hydrogen proton, that is 3 plus 1 quartet. So we will get two hydrogen quartet, and for this proton we will get a broad singlet, because there is only one proton, and in oxygen there is no hydrogen attached, only one hydrogen is attached. So we will get only one signal for this proton. Now if you see the chemical shift values for CH3, it is attached with sp3 hybridized carbon, so this will around 1.2. and if you see this carbon is sp3 hybridized and also attached to oxygen, which is more electronegative. So the chemical shift value for this CH3 will be less than this CH2, and this CH2 have more than chemical shift value than CH3, because hetero atom is attached. Because of this hetero atom, that is more electronegative atom, some electron density will be less here. That's why the chemical shift value will be more for this CH2. If you see the highest chemical shift value, that is 4.5 around for this proton, single proton, because of this is directly attached to the electronegative oxygen atom. That's why it is come around 4.5. So this much information for this question is sufficient. Now how to interpret proton NMR spectra. Now that we have had an introduction to key aspect of 1H NMR spectra, like chemical shape, peak area, signal splitting, you can start to apply 1H NMR spectroscopy to illustrating the structure of unknown compounds. And these are the following structure illustrating process. Count the number of signal in the spectrum to determine how many distinct proton environment are there in the molecule. So you have to calculate first how many signals are there. Neglecting for the time being the possibility of overlapping signals, you will see later that in some cases there are some overlapping of signal will also find, that we will not see in this video, we will see in later videos. Then in the second point, you use the chemical shift table or chart, or you may have some experience over time, and correlate the chemical shift to the signal with possible structural environment. Then the third point is determine the relative areas of each signal as compared with the area of other signal as an indication of relative number of protons producing the signal. Then interpret the splitting pattern of each signal to determine how many hydrogens atoms are present on carbon atoms adjacent to those producing the signal, and sketch the possible molecular fragments. Then join the fragments to make the molecule in fashion that consists with that data. So I will give you one problem, and you can apply all these steps in that problem and illustrate the molecular structure using these steps. As a beginning example, we shall interpret the 1H NMR spectrum, which is seen in the figure, for a compound with molecular formula C3H7Br. So you can see the spectra. We have three signal along with DMS. So this is appearing, you can see in 1 ppm there is a triplet for 3 proton. You can see this integration values, 3 protons, 2 protons and 2 protons. So for this triplet we have 3 protons. For this 2 protons there will be a sextet, and for this C proton that will be 2 proton, that will also a triplet. Now how to interpret the structure? Let's see. For this proton B we are getting sextet, that means in the neighboring hydrogen, neighboring carbon, there should be 5 hydrogen. That means this CH2, which is you can see this CH2 must have CH3 group here and CH2 group here, then only this will give a sextet. Then if you see this A proton, this is giving triplet, that means this A proton having 3 hydrogen, that means this 3 hydrogen only give triplet if the neighboring hydrogen has neighboring carbon has 2 hydrogen. So this will be remaining one clue for this compound. Then we see the C proton, that means this have a 2 proton and this is showing triplet, that means this must attached with another CH2. So this must be like this, that means for this 2 proton the neighboring carbon having 2 hydrogen, so this will give only triplet. Now you can get some idea that we have all the carbons and all the protons. You can see 3 carbon, 1, 2, 3, we have 3 carbons and 7 hydrogen, CH3, CH2, CH2, so 3, 2, 5, 2, 7, so remaining is 1 bromide, so we can attach here. So the structure will look like this. You can see CH3, CH2, CH2, Br. Now come to the chemical shift value. So the carbon which is attached to directly electronegative atom having that CH2 will have more chemical shift, that means it will showing here 3 above this C proton, that means this peak is referring to these hydrogens. And whichever you can see here the sextet, you can predict that it is attached with 2 sp2 sp3 hybridized carbon atom, and this carbon also attached with an electronegative atom, so there will be some electron density less here, so this will come around 1.9. and if you see this 3 hydrogen, it is directly attached to sp3 hybridized carbon atom, so it will remain as 1 ppm. So I think this is helpful.